Hello, Mr. Niren here, so I'm gonna show you how to install Wrath of the Norsemen with the new M2TWEOP-tool or Medieval Total War Engine Overhaul Project tool. I released a new version with the tool in on December 5th, I believe, or 4th, 2020, but I didn't make a new installation video. The one that Satchman did, or the Super U did, is outdated. Okay, so the first thing you need to do, as usual, is to go to google.com and then write winrar. The first thing that shows up should be this. You click there and then you download this tool and install it anywhere on your computer. This is the symbol of the archives using this tool or program. So you will see that any file using this symbol is a rare archive that can be opened with this tool. Go to my files here, and then when you right click on this, you can extract folders. If you do it this way, you will have an archive. Wait a second, we will first go to, when you have the WinRAR program installed, you go to Google and then you search for WinRAR and then you install it. And then after that, you go to modbay.com. Then you should get this view, the front page of Modbay, the modding site. Then you search for Wrath of the Norsemen. You get two options. The first one is the correct one. The other one is the never the unfinished grand campaign. You should click on this one. And you see Wrath of the Norsemen Medieval Total War Kingdoms mod released Death 3 2009. It was on Death 3. Okay, I said wrongly, 4th or 5th. Okay, it was Death 3. Okay, we can expand this window to see some more info. And an old video from the summer of 2017. The changes from back then. I believe I had a later video, but it was removed because it used music from certain artists, and for some reason they didn't want it on YouTube. Okay, so we have an article here that you can read about the latest changes and some installation instructions and such. You can also find the download links for the mod in this article. You have download Wrath of the Norsemen, the Baltic Beta 3.3, that's the latest version, the one that is using the tool. It's that one we are doing an installation video about. There is another sub-mod that is not using the tool, and it's not a part of this installation video. Okay, so Wrath of the Norsemen Beta 3.3, you can click here to get directly to the installation, to the download area, download section. Or you can continue to read, and then go down to the, you can see some older articles here, and then here you have two files. Wrath of the Norsemen Regnum Francorum 1.6.5, which is a submod made by another guy, a young guy, where he added, I believe in the original mod you can play as the Franks, the Eastern Franks, but they are not really playable, they will go bankrupt very fast, and they were not supposed to be played, and their economy will not last for long, so it's probably impossible to play as the Franks in 3.3. That's why he made a sub-mod where he made the Regnum Francorum a fully playable faction. And the focus of this sub-mod was on the Frankish faction. Okay, and he also added new building pictures, new features and such. But they are different. This one plays more like an like an ordinary mod. You choose a faction and you play the game. Sure, it still tries to be historically accurate, but it plays more like an ordinary mod, while the real Wrath of the Norsemen, the Baltic release Beta 3.3, is true to the original idea of having a very, what should I say, hardcore campaign. So it's very hardcore, and the economy isn't easy. For example, as the Norsemen and other barbarians, it will be hard to get money. You can't just sit in your settlements forever and expect to earn money. You need to go out and raid, or you will get bankrupt. Well, this mod doesn't have this as a problem. Here you can just sit in your settlements and build up, I believe, like in any other mode. But this one is more, it's trying to be more close to history. So as a Viking faction, you will need to expand and expand and expand and raid lots of areas, or you get bankrupt. Okay, but anyway, back to installation. So you can click on, you only need one of these, they are standalone mods. So if you want to play this one, you only download this, and if you want to play this one, you only download this. You shouldn't mix them or merge them or whatever. Click on this one if you want 3.3 version. You can see that it's a full version. Added July 14th, 2017, updated December 3rd, 2020, when I added the tool and the berserk function to the berserkers and Ulf Hednars of the mod. And I also changed the models of the Ulf Hednars and the berserkers, or berserkers, so that they would have a two-handed axe instead of shield and a one-handed axe. Because the berserk mental state has a unique animation when they are berserk, which makes the unit roll around, and it looked bad with the shield and the one-handed weapon. It looks better with the two-handed weapon, so of course it doesn't look as good as in Rome to the War, because that mod had different animations. Here they just have a placeholder animation, so it won't crash, but in Rome to the War they had the proper cool berserk animation. I wish someone would add that to Medieval 2. Okay, because that one looks way better. Okay, but anyway, the mod size in our rare archive is 1.4 GB. So you download the mod after you have installed the WinRAR program. You will then have a rare archive. And if you extract the rare archive through these buttons, you will get a folder, an ordinary folder, named WOTN or VOTN, and inside of that folder, I believe in this case it will be named VOTN Baltic 2. VOTN Baltic.2 will be the folder when you extract it. So then inside of the VOTN Baltic.2 you will find the VOTN Baltic folder, and that's the mod folder that you need to place in the mods area of your Medieval Total War game. So for the CD version, you will go to your computer and whichever hard drive you installed on, C or D, and then you go to D. You shouldn't have Medieval 2 installed in program files x86, because on modern computers with Windows as the operative system, the operative system has some security updates that installed automatically, that made any game installed in the program files folder have a clone drive. So if you modify any of the games in this folder, there is a risk that the modified files won't have an effect in the game. They won't affect the game because there is a clone drive of the game somewhere, and then the computer will load that clone instead of the modified files. So by creating a games folder in the D drive, like I did, and place the Sega folder here, which includes the Medieval Total War folder, which includes the mods folder, then you won't have that issue, because any mod modified here will have the changes in the game. Okay, so we have VU10, the VU10 Baltic here, so you need to place that folder here, and then when you enter it, you see that it already has the tool and everything. So on the CD version, it already comes with First Medieval Total War, which is separate from the Kingdoms expansion, so you get the medieval2.exe automatically when you install the game, and then when you install the expansion you get the kingdoms.exe. You still need probably to install the 4 GB patch. I'm not sure if it's required on Wrath of the Norsemen, but to be safe I would install the 4 GB patch or the large address aware patch. So you'd run these files, they can be downloaded, search on Google or find them on Warcraft Total War on its page, or find them in the download of Hyrule Total War Classic Ultimate. Okay, and there are probably other mods too that has the files, like for example Warhammer Beginning of the End Times. Then you go to the Medieval 2 main folder. Now we are on Steam, but it's the same process with CD. You select the medieval2.exe and click open, and it will apply the patch. Then you open, then you click another file, and then you do the same to the Kingdoms file. You need to do this on both the CD version and the Steam version. And with the large address aware patch, which is a similar patch, an alternative, you can run as an administrator, browse here, find the file, make sure this is checked, and then click save, then do the same to the other. So the 4GB patch is not the program, by the way. It's a patch. So the original Medieval Total War the original Medieval Total War Kingdoms game and many other games released in 2005, 2006, 2007 or such old games, they could only make use of 2GB of RAM memory. So even if your computer has 4GB of RAM, 8GB of RAM, 16GB of RAM or 32GB of RAM memory, the game could only make use of 2GB of RAM. And that's pretty, what should I say, outdated. And most mods are using updated models, updated city models, updated battlefield textures. Usually they are in HD in modern mods, and usually the games, you should say, you could say that Medieval Total War Kingdoms is an old game from 2006. I believe the Medieval Total War game is from 2006, and the Kingdoms expansion from 2007. And the models there are pretty old, and the battlefields and their textures too are old. So they are not that demanding anymore on modern computers. And as such, could even the game could even run well on old computers, relatively old computers. But for example, it could run on a Windows XP from 2005, I believe. But many mods can't be run on Windows XP computers from 2005 because of the new models and the new enhanced textures and graphics. And even on modern computers, the game would crash a lot when trying to start campaigns or playing battles, etc., if you do not use this patch or the large address aware patch, because the game is unable to make use of any more than 2GB of RAM memory. So by using the 4GB RAM patch, 4GB patch means 4GB RAM memory patch, it enables for the game to make use of 4GB of RAM memory instead of 2GB of RAM memory. So it can, when you have used this patch, it can play games, old games, and make use of twice as much RAM memory as it could in the past, which makes the mods much more stable. So mods that used to crash will not crash as much, because now you have twice as much RAM memory that the game is actually able to make use of, because you are patching the .exe files of the old game so that the .exe can make use of twice as much memory. Okay, and the large address aware patch is the same stuff, but if the 4GB patch doesn't work, then you can try the other one. Okay, so many modern mods won't work without these patches. So you need to patch the .exe files. But I've heard that some people using the 4GB patch might not be able to patch their files. They will get an error message when trying to use the 4GB patch. And that's when I suggest using the large address aware patch instead. If that doesn't work, then you're out of luck. One reason it might not work is because if you have an old computer, let's say you have a Windows XP from 2005, and that computer only has 3GB of RAM memory, then you can't use the 4GB patch, because you need to have a computer that has 4GB of RAM memory or more to use this patch. And I think it's the same for the large address aware patch. So if your computer is too weak or too old, it won't be able to use the patch and the mods won't work. Then you need then to update your computer to a computer with more RAM. Okay, so that's about the patching. When that's done, so we're on the CD version, you patch the .exe files, then you go to mods, and you place the V10 Baltic folder here, and then about the M2TWEOP-tool, your firewall or antivirus might see the tool as a virus or a Trojan. So in order to prevent that, because the firewall and the antivirus will move this M2TWEOP.exe file to the trash can, and in order to prevent that from happening, you need to make an exception for this .exe file in your firewall settings or in your antivirus settings. Alternatively, you need to disable your firewall and antivirus. Also, for many mods to work, you need to go to control panel, to the control panel, and then you need to find the user account control section, UAC section, and disable it. Otherwise, it will interfere with mods working. Mods won't work as intended, because that UAC function, security function of modern computers like Windows 10 computers, it will interfere with mods. So you need to disable it and make an exception for the tool. When you have done that, you can start the game using the tool. You click on run as an administrator. Now it didn't start because I moved over it to an older version of Wrath of the Norsemen, but it should be similar to with other mods. We'll check the Steam version then. So with Steam, the only difference is that it's located in, I installed it on the new volume drive. Okay, so then we have computer and new volume, and then we have Steam, and then we have Steam apps, and then we have common, and then we have medieval total war, where you need to first of all copy the medieval2.exe file. You need to right click on the medieval2.exe, then click on copy, and then paste it here, and then rename the copied file to kingdoms, because unlike with the CD, the Steam version do not come with the kingdoms expansion. It's part of the main medieval 2 version for Steam, but certain mods need the kingdoms exe in this folder, in the medieval 2 total war folder, in order to start, or it will give you an error message stating that you lack the kingdoms.exe file. So to install this, you need to right click here, copy the file, paste, and rename to kingdoms. So you have two files here. Then you need to do the same thing I just showed. You need to patch these two files with the 4GB patch or the large address aware patch. I don't think you need to use both, but one of them is needed to make mods work without crashing all the time, because as I said, they are more demanding than you can compare a mod to a new game. You can see the vanilla game as an older game, and the mod, it's the same game at the core, but it's updated in many areas. Mostly the models are much better and improved, and for them to work without crashing, you need to enable the 4GB patch or the large address aware patch. And then you go to the mod section where you place the V10 Baltic folder. So you have the same folder here, and you need to do the same thing here, so that the antivirus or firewall do not remove this file. And when it's not removed, you can start it up, just like with the CD. And if you get this music from the vanilla game, usually when you start the game, it will get silenced. Otherwise, you need to, unfortunately, believe you need to go to your audio and the volume control and move this to the bottom, like this, so you don't have that music playing at the same time as the mod's music, because that music is the music of the tools menu here. And for some reason it didn't stop playing when I started the mod, for some reason. Okay, so here I have already made this the V10 beta.cfg, so I've written V10 beta here, so it will load the correct CFG file. in the mod folder. All of these are already selected. Don't change any of these. And if you are not a modder, don't change these either. It's certain options you can increase or decrease the religion limit and children's limit, etc. But do not touch these if you are not a modder, and you should know what you're doing before touching these. And do not touch these either. They are as they should. As for these options, they might cause the game to lag in battles. So I suggest disabling this one, and this one, and only enable the creatures fix and the berserks fix. Then apply changes. So there are no elephants in Wrath of the Norsemen, but to be sure, to be secure, just have it enabled. It is fixing the... actually, maybe not, because it will mess up the certain animations for horses. For Wrath of the Norsemen, you do not need the creature fix either. There are no elephants, giants or such, so just disable that one too. The only one that you need is the berserks fix, which enables the berserk mental state in battle. The vanilla game, it will crash whenever a unit using the berserk mental state reaches the enemy on the battlefield. But this fix will fix it, so only have this one selected here and you won't have lag, and it should work fine. You need this one selected, but the other ones could be deselected, it's fine. Okay, and do not click start vanilla. Vanilla means the original game. If you click here, you start Medieval Total War Kingdoms. If you click start mod, you will run the actual mod, so that's where you want to click. Okay, but before you can... let's say, so when you have this screen like this, then you click start mod to start the game with the mod running. But if you are on a Windows 7 and using the CD, it will work fine like this. If you are on a Windows 10 with the CD, it will also work fine like this. But if you are on Windows 10 with the Steam version, it won't work fine. It could work fine in some cases, but for some players there has been an issue where the screen of the mod is just a tiny box in the corner of your computer or TV screen. So you would have Wrath of the Norsemen be like this little screen, and the rest be a desktop, like be your desktop. Computer desktop. So in order to fix this, you need to do one final step. So you go to the article, you find this picture, you can right click on it and then open in a new image in a new window tab, in a new tab, and you get a zoomed in view. So here we can read, I tried it on Windows 7, no issues. I tried it with the CD version on Windows 10, no issues. But according to the creators of the tool, it is required to change some stuff for the Steam version on Windows 10. You do need to right-click on the medieval2.exe/kingdoms.exe and change some things in the compatibility mode. It will also need to be done with the tools.exe file. This is due to the scaling settings of Windows 10. So what you need to do is, you need to open file properties of those three files. So we need to go back to, this is only for the Steam version on Windows 10. So you need to go to Steam, Steam Apps, Common, Medieval Total War, the main Medieval Total War folder, where you have the .exe files of Medieval 2, Medieval2.exe and the Kingdoms.exe, and you need to right click on both of them. You can start with the Medieval 2 one. Then you click on Properties, and then you click on Compatibility. And this one looks a little different because I'm on Windows 7, but on Windows 10 it will look like this. So you right click on the .exe files, then you get to this screen, you will right click this one, I believe, the one that has to do with DPI settings, and then you click here. Then you get to this screen where you will select this area and then click OK. That's what you need to do. So it states you need to open file properties, compatibility, change DPI settings, check the box and select application. This option also helps with Med 2 for some players. Plus 20 FPS, set DPI scale to control by application. Alright, and then you should have the mod start in full screen mode. Okay, and you need to do this to both the .exe files here in the Medieval Total War main folder of Steam. And then you need to go to VTN Baltic, and you need to do the same thing to the M2TWEOP-tool here. properties after right clicking compatibility and do the same here. And that's for Steam only. And then when you start the mod, so you have this one open, you make sure only Berserk Fix is checked here and click apply changes, then you click start mod. And the mod will start. Right of the Norsemen, you have the M2TWEOP-tool here. And the mod starts.